see you come in. I was just reading 2001 A Space Odyssey by Arthur C. Clarke. Hello, my name's Elliot. You may know me as the Immature Student. And today, I want to talk to you about how to read more. When I started as a student, you could say that I was woefully ill-equipped. When I was a child, when I was growing up, I struggled to read. I really did. I always wanted to be a storyteller and a writer from a young age, and I devoured stories voraciously when I was very young. As I began to grow, got into primary school and secondary school, my ability to read tapered off to the point where I would only really read a chapter a day. It may take me 3 months, it may take me longer to read a single novel. That gets tiring. When you're immersed in a story for that long, it's tiring. And as a result, I did not read nearly as much as I should have. I missed out on a lot of stories through those years. When I got a bit older and realized that normal work wasn't for me, because come on, office politics is stupid, I decided I wanted to try this whole writing life, be a writer. One of the greatest living authors alive, Stephen King, obviously living author alive, a living author dead, wouldn't be a living author. Stephen King famously said that if you do not have the time to read, you don't have the time to write, or the tools to write. In short, what he was saying was that in order to write well, you must read widely. You have to read to absorb the craft, how other people are writing, what you do like, what you don't like, and learn from reading. Now that I'm at university studying creative writing, one of my lecturers has a similar saying. He always says, good reading in, good writing out. It's the same thing. And I knew before I went to university and when I started writing again that one, I needed to read more fiction so I could become a better writer. And two, I would need to read for university. I would have recommended reading. I would need to study. So I needed to increase my reading speed. So I did exactly what you've done right now. I turned to YouTube, and most of it didn't help. But don't turn off, because I'm going to give you guys the truth, okay? When you turn on and you see all these things about speed reading techniques and how you can read a book a week or a book a day and their quote-unquote inspirational videos about how people have become millionaires because they read a book a day. Frankly, no one can read a book a day. That is a fact, like a cold hard fact. If you have a job, if you eat, if you want to do other things, like yes, you could read a book in one day if all you did was read. But nobody has the time to read a book every day and also run a business to become a multi-millionaire. Those people are lying. This is just a fact, okay? You just have to swallow that. Nobody can read that fast. How do I know this? Well, it's all rooted in science. So the reason that magic pill reading techniques don't work is that reading is an act of moving your eyes from one point on the page to another and absorbing the information. There is a genetic limit, a mechanical limit to how fast your eyes can move. There are genetic outliers, people whose eyes can move faster and some people whose eyes can move slower. But ultimately, no matter how much you practice, there will be an upper speed limit to how many words you can read in a minute. And that, simply put, means that there are no magic techniques that stop this from being a factor. Couple with that when you read quickly, when you really try to push the speed at which you read, then you struggle with comprehension and you don't really take in the information. You misread words, you misunderstand sentences. If you're trying to read to take in either a story or you're reading a factual book to take in information, then if you struggle to read too quickly, you'll just miss most of the information. So I have two useful things to tell you. One is that people say in order to master a skill, you must practice it for 10,000 hours. This means that in order for you to become a faster reader, you must first become a more regular reader. Reading every day and reading a good quantity will just naturally increase your reading speed. So the more often you read, and the more you read in each sitting, in future, the more quickly you'll be able to read in each sitting and in each space of time. Secondly, knowing that there's an upper limit to how quickly you can read, all you can do is give time to reading. There's no reason that people who read considerably more books than you can read more than you. It's not that they can read more quickly in most cases. It's that they dedicate more time to reading. Most people watch TV for at least 3 hours in an evening. If you cut that down to two and read for 1 hour, you will dramatically increase the amount you read in a short space of time. So I'm going to go straight in with the techniques that I use. And these are not magic pill techniques. This is just genuinely how I read. How I went from reading one book in 3 months to reading 12 books in 1 month. Or in other words, roughly a book a week. At this point in time, I'm actually reading 2 books a week because I'm reading 2 books simultaneously. And I will say asterisks up here, approximately a week. So some books are longer than others and take longer to read. But here's how I do it. I set myself a page limit, not limit, but a page target per day. And I read this 98% of the time. If I have a day trip, or if I'm on holiday, or if I'm going to a barbecue, you know, there will be days when I won't make that page count. But I will always try and read at least a couple of pages. But 98% of the time, I will read 50 pages of the fiction I'm reading at the moment and 50 pages of the academic text I'm reading at the moment. Now, as an example, I will turn to my bookcase. Bram Stoker's Dracula, a very famous book, and a book that if you've read, you may well be considered a more well-rounded, more well-read person. A more intelligent person, perhaps. Maybe you want to talk about Dracula. Dracula is not that big a book. The text is fairly small, but the book is 314 pages long. If you read it 50 pages a day, and this is religiously 50 pages a day, you will complete this book in 7 days. 6 days of reading 50 pages and 1 day of reading 14 pages. That's a book in a week. That's a classic book, that's a great book, and that's kind of your average length book. So your average length book is going to take you between 7 and 8 days to read. There are books that take longer. Currently, I'm trying to devour Stephen King's Dark Tower series. So Wolves of the Calla, book 5, is probably one of the biggest books I've ever read. It's a tome. It's huge. I'm currently on page 520, and I've been reading that for 10 days. There are, I think, 770 pages, so I have a way left. It'll take me about 14 days in total to read that book. But 14 days to read one of the biggest books I've ever read, while simultaneously reading an academic book, these books over here, to help me with my university studies. If I keep up this pace and read generally average size books, books that are around 50,000 words in length, which is your average novel, then I will be reading nearly 100 books in 1 year, in 12 months, nearly 100 books. If you read just 50 pages of one book at one time, you'll be reading 48 books, roughly, in a year. And if you don't tell me that when you've read 48 books, you're not a pretty well-read person, then I would argue that compared to most people you walk up to and talk to in the street, you should never walk into people, but walk up to, most people will not have read 48 books in their life. You could read 48 books in a year, assuming you kept up with that pace of reading. For 2 years, you'd read nearly 100 books. In 4 years, you'd read nearly 200 books. You know, it scales incredibly well. That year, those 6 months, those 4 years will pass whether you read or just sit on your ass watching TV. If you really want to read more and you really want to be well-read, the only thing you can do is read more. As I say, I set myself a page limit because different books have different size font and different size pages, and sometimes they have pictures, etc. So you just don't know. 50 pages might take you 20 minutes of one book, or it might take you 2 hours from another book. That's why I go page count, because I can work out exactly how many pages I need to read a book in a week. Sometimes it will be 50, sometimes it will be 75. I personally am happy to read 50 pages of each book a day because it's a bit of a challenge, because normally I hit about 30 pages and I'm like, well, I'm kind of tired, I want to stop, but I keep going. And I'm happy to not try and read 70, 75, because, you know, if a long book takes me 2 weeks, that's fine. I'll read something short after, and I can plow off 2 books in 1 week, and I can just keep up with my pace of approximately 100 books in 1 year. And that's really all there is to it. I'm sorry to say that there is no magic pill. There is no way to read much more than I believe the upper limit that that sort of scientists and studies agree on is about 500 to 600 words per minute, which is probably far faster than I read. I'm probably closer to like 300 words per minute. And yet, I read far, far more than a lot of other people I know. On kind of a bell curve of eye movement speed, I'm probably only about halfway. I'm not fast. I'm not terribly slow, but I'm not fast. I know people who can read way quicker than me. But I have still read more books than most of those, and that's really only in a few years, because prior to going to university and prior to before starting to read, try and write again, I, you know, would read one book every 3 months. So between the ages of 1 and 25, 26, I maybe read 30 books. And now I've read, I don't know how many because I haven't kept a tally, but I've read a hell of a lot more in that time since. 50 pages a day, that's my number. If you want to start with 10 and then build up to 12 and then to 15 and then to 20, fine. You know, set it for how many books you want to read. If you want to read 25 books in a year, 25 books in a year, read 20, 25 pages a day. That's like half an hour in most books. And you will read more. That's really it. You just have to sit down and read. Maybe put some classical music on, get a cup of tea, do whatever makes you comfortable, sit down in a quiet place, and just read. And that's all there is to reading more. It's not magic, and it's not probably what most of you wanted to hear, but once you've done it for a few weeks, it becomes easy. Peace and love, my friends. I will see all of you in the next video.